Hi all, welcome to Tech Forum. In this video, let us talk about the code quality for AEM projects. In our earlier videos, we have seen how to use JCogo, Maven and SonarQube in Docker container to measure and enable the required quality for Java projects. Refer to these videos for more details. Set up SonarQube in a Docker container and bootstrap the quality configurations. Then Sonar linked connected mode with Eclipse and SonarQube. Then another one is code coverage report with JCogo, Maven and SonarQube. Code quality is important for overall software quality as it measures how safe, secure and reliable the application code base. The code quality testing evaluates the quality of your application code. In code quality testing, the source code is scanned to make sure the code meets certain quality criteria. AEM Cloud Manager CI/CD pipeline uses SonarQube and OakPAL content rules to statically analyze the code and the content. Refer to this specific video, beginner's tutorial, what is Cloud Manager for Adobe Experience Manager to get more details on Cloud Manager. The Cloud Manager tests for security, reliability, maintainability, code coverage, script unit test, open issues, and duplicated lines of code. The Cloud Manager is enabled only for the AMS, means Adobe Managed Services, or AEM as a cloud service customers. Cloud Manager enables custom SonarQube rules to scan the code. You can refer to this URL to get more details on the custom code quality rules. The SonarQube rule plugin used by Cloud Manager is not shared, but the rules can be referred from here, this URL, as a Excel. Let me download that. This lists out all the rules enabled as part of the Cloud Manager SonarQube. SonarQube enabled with specific quality gates, refer here, security rating, category is critical, then failure threshold is less than B. If it is less than B, it is failed. Then reliability rating, again important, less than C. Maintainability rating, important, less than A. Code coverage, it's important, it's less than 50% means it's failed. It should be minimum 50%. Then skipped unit test, greater than 1 means it's failed. Open issues greater than 0, duplicated lines greater than 1%. For each of the above mentioned quality gates, Adobe introduced the concept of the 3-tier result. Critical, these are issues identified by the gate which cause an immediate failure. Important, these are issues identified by the gate which cause the pipeline to enter a past state. Means a deployment manager or project manager, business owner can either override the issues. In that case, the pipeline proceeds, or they can accept the issues, in which case the pipeline stops with a failure. Then info, these are issues identified by the gate which are provided for informational purposes and have no impact on the pipeline execution. In this video, let us see how to set up code quality scan and analysis in local through SonarQube and other plugins to measure the code quality during development. The SonarQube rule plugins used by Cloud Manager is not shared, but custom rules from this specific repository, Cognified AEM rules for SonarQube, can be used in our local SonarQube to enable the required code quality. This contains rules for both Java and HTML files. The release plugin can be downloaded from here, releases, then the latest release is 1.3, Sonar AEM rules plugin 1.3.jar. Even if you want, you can download other versions also. Let us now see how to use Docker to set up the SonarQube and bootstrap the quality rules and gates. I have created an extended SonarQube container that enabled with Cognified AEM rules and project specific custom rule. So this is the location, SonarQube with custom plugins AEM, TechForum Docker container. So you can just go and run this also. It's already bootstrapped with the required quality gates and also the AEM rules. Also project specific custom rule. So you can execute either one of this command. So this is like, if you use this, the configurations are persisted between stop and start. Specify the data and log folder in your local system that is mounted to this specific folder of OPT SonarQube data and OPT SonarQube logs. So this data will be persisted. So whenever you start the SonarQube container again, the same data will be used. So this bootstrapping configuration, all those things will be stored. It will not redo that steps every time. Actual configuration is stored here. If I go to that project, even you can extend this Docker container, modify the configurations under this, and you can build it. You can read through the steps how to build the extended container. Let me quickly show the Docker file. So here the important thing is I am adding those plugins. So if you see here the second line, Sonar AEM rules plugin, the latest plugin I am adding 1.3. I'm directly adding through this URL. Also, I have a custom project enabled with a rule. That's I'm adding here. Latest Sonar custom project rules 1.0.0. So this is a sample project, the custom rule project. You can have your own custom project to add additional project specific rules. This will help you to automate all the code quality rules for your project. All the quality gate definitions are enabled into this file, aemqualitygate.json, under this conf folder. Let me open that. Enable different quality gate definitions. The first one is blocker violations, operator greater than, error 0. If it is greater than 0, the quality gate will fail. The same way, command line density, then you can specify the operator whatever you want, here less than 20. Then critical violations, operator greater than 0. If the critical violation is greater than 0, the quality gate will fail. The same way, then the major one is coverage, operator less than 75. If the coverage is less than 75, the quality gate will fail. But yeah, same way with the other one, security rating, error equal to 1, greater than, then it will fail. Then reliability rating, same, operator greater than, error equal to 1. You can define your own quality gate definitions. If you see code coverage, my case it's 75%, but you can change according to your project need. Same way with the critical violations, my case 0, you can adjust it. You can define other rules also accordingly. Reliability rating, security rating, code smells, major violations and other things. The configure.bash file configure the required quality profiles and quality gates. Let me show that. You can refer here. The quality gate definition is in the JSON file. This bash file read that and create the quality gate. Yeah, this creates the quality gate and the required quality conditions. Also, this creates the quality profile. We are creating the quality profile with name AEM way Java. Then we are changing the parent of the quality profile. Here if you see AEM way Java inherit from this Sonar way. So Sonar way is the parent. So this will have all the rules available in the Sonar way, additional to the custom rules. Then we are making there is a default quality profile, AEM way Java. Then we are associating the required custom rule repository. See here, AEM rules, common HTL. These are part of cognified AEM rule repository. Then custom project rules, it's from my custom project. One more thing what we are doing is we are changing the default admin password. The required password can be specified while starting the container. You can extend this Docker container with your custom rules and other configuration so that you can set up the quality gate for your project. Let me quickly start the Docker container. Ensure the Docker is installed in your machine. I installed Docker desktop on Windows machine. I'm going to execute this specific command. Fine, I'm going to execute through WSL window. So fine, I'm execute. First time it may take some time because it will be bootstrapping the configurations also. Now the SonarQube server is up with the bootstrapped configuration. You can see the trace here. These are all the steps executed while starting the SonarQube server to create the quality gate and the quality profiles. Let us quickly review the configurations. Localhost 9000 projects. There is no project created now. Let me go to quality profiles. AEM way Java, that is the default and inherited from Sonar way. There are total 436 rules, but the Sonar way is having 422. Remaining rules are custom rules. Then let me go to quality gates. If you see here, there is a quality gate with the name AEM, that's default. And all the conditions defined in the JSON file are created here. Let us now quickly generate the report on the AEM sample project. This project was created through archetype 23. This is just a sample project. I did not done any modification. I'm going to execute this specific command, mbn clean install sonar colon sonar. Now the code analysis completed and uploaded the report to SonarQube. Let me quickly go to the console. So let me refresh it, maybe go to projects. Yeah, I can see the new project here, AEM quality project. It shows all the quality metrics. And also if you see coverage is right now 0.0, that we can see it later. Then code smells, yeah. You can even click here and go and see the more details. So if you see here the failed, the quality gate is failed because the code coverage is 0, expectation is 75%. And also there is a blocker issue, but expectation is 0. Then code smells 10, but expectation is 1. Same way comments, then critical issue, there are 2. Major issues too. So the quality gate is overall failed. This report helps us to address the quality issues. Let us now see how to use Eclipse plugin SonarLint to analyze the code during the development. SonarLint enables connected mode to use the rules and quality gate defined in the SonarQube. SonarLint uses the standard rule sets and won't allow you to add the custom rules. But the connected mode can use the custom rules from SonarQube server. Refer to this video for more details on SonarLint connected mode. As a first step, install the SonarLint plugin. For that, go to Help, Eclipse Marketplace. Search for SonarLint. Then install this specific plugin. Let me quickly enable the connected mode. For that, go to Window, Show View, Other, search for Sonar. Yeah, select this SonarLint bindings. Find connect to SonarQube or SonarCloud. I am going with the SonarQube. Then next, here enter HTTP localhost 9000. Let's find, click on next. Yeah, you can use the token. Token can be generated through console or username password. I am going with this. Next, admin, my case welcome one, wcaps. Yeah, connection name, David localhost. This is fine. Click on finish. Yeah, now you can bind the project. Here I am going to click on add, then selecting this core project. Also, I am going to add the UI apps folder. Fine. Click on next. Here I should be selecting the remote project. So here if I select again AEM quality project, this is fine. Click on finish. Yeah, now that is fine. If I go to that window again, yeah, right click on this and say update all project bindings. So now during that time, if you go to the console, SonarLint console, if you go here, yep, you can see all these quality gates and rules all are getting downloaded from SonarQube server. You can see the details here. The AEM rules for SonarQube 1.3, it's downloaded. Also, if you see, yeah, Sonar custom project rules. This is my custom project rule. Let me quickly run the plugin. For that, right click this SonarLint, then say analyze. There are multiple issues. Let me select this. And if I go, there is a window, SonarLint rule selection. So this will show you the details of the rule. Optional is defined as default injection strategy, AEM rules, AEM 16. Usage of optional, at optional is redundant. So we can remove that. So if I go to that again, click on this. Yeah, if you see here, this class level default injection strategy is optional. Again, we are specifying at optional annotation. So this is redundant so that we can remove this. Let me now quickly run it for UI apps. Right click again, SonarLint analyze. Yeah, there is no issues with this UI apps project. Let us quickly compare the report between the SonarQube console and this. So let me go to the console. Let me go to issues. Yeah, you see here there is multiple issues. Yeah, we have this optional defined as default injection strategy. Let me come down. Yeah, if you see here, there is one additional issue. Avoid using unsafe display context. This disables XSS protection completely. If I click on this, why this is an issue? This is coming from STL rule. Header libs.html under apps. But this issue was not reported by SonarLint. If I go back here, yeah, when I ran this, there is zero issue. But if I open the page custom header libs.html, I have the same unsafe configuration. One of the restrictions with the connected mode is the rules enabled through custom analyzer will not be considered by SonarLint plugin. In our case, STL rule was enabled through custom analyzer. You can refer this cognified rule repository. You can understand. The rule repository uses custom analyzer to analyze the STL code. Let us now see how to enable the code coverage. Right now the code coverage is zero. So for that, as a first step, enable the JUnit test cases. In sample project, test cases are already enabled. If I show you, yeah, filter, logging filter test. Yeah, this is having all the test cases enabled. Same case for listeners, models, schedulers, and servlets. You should enable the JUnit test cases for your custom classes. Maybe in another video, we can discuss on enabling JUnit test cases for different scenarios. We are going to use JCoCo Maven plugin for measuring the code coverage. Let us now enable the JCoCo Maven plugin. Let me go to the parent pom.xml, add these properties, jcogo version 08.6, sonar language java, sonar.java.coverage plugin jcogo, then sonar exclusions, we are going to exclude this pom.xml. Also, I am going to exclude this server-side test.java files within this it.test project, then sonar dynamic analysis reuse report, then sonar coverage jcogo xml report path, this is mandatory. So I am using this multi-module project directory property. This is the root directory. This property is available only in the latest Maven. Then core target site jcogo jcogo.xml. This file will be created during the analysis. Let me uncomment this. Okay, this is fine. Then also we should be enabling the jcogo Maven plugin. So this is the one. So what we are doing is jcogo Maven plugin, prepare unit test, initialize phase, then the goal is prepare agent. Let me now go to core project pom.xml. Again, we should be enabling this report goal. Let me uncomment this. Jcogo Maven plugin, ID default report, goal is report. Let me quickly analyze the project again. The analysis completed now. Let me go to the core module location. So if I go here, yeah, AEM quality project core, go to target. Then there is a folder called site. Open that, jcogo, then index.html. Just to click on that. You can see now the code coverage is 100%. If I open one of these models, hello model, again 100%. You can see all the details also. If I go to here, yeah, you see the JUnit test covering complete core. Let me quickly go to SonarQube console. If I click on projects, yeah, now you see coverage 100%. Even you can click on this project. If you go to overall code and come down, you can see 100%. Click on that, you will see all the details here. If you again open this, you can see the code coverage is 100%. Let us now see how to generate the code coverage report directly from Eclipse. For that, we should be installing ECLMR plugin. Let me go to help, Eclipse marketplace, search for ECLMR and install this plugin. Now right click on core module, go to coverage as JUnit test. Yeah, now you can see the coverage report 100%. Even you can drill down to this, click on this and go to filters, even 100%, you can click on and go to the actual file and see what lines are covered. Anyhow, this case is 100%. Otherwise, you can improve the unit testing. The SonarQube in Docker container with the cognified AEM rules along with the custom rules will help us to set the consistent quality requirement during project development. The quality gate can be defined based on the quality requirement of the project. This is very useful to maintain the consistent quality across different teams. Also, this reduces the manual code review efforts and the process can be automated through required custom rules. That's all for today. Thanks all for watching the video. See you in the next video.